The PAP attack.
During that last town hall meeting, I wasn't sure whether or not Tom Brokaw might actually stand up and kiss John McCain on the cheek. You know, Brokaw's always felt a need to have heroes in his life, and I can understand that. We all are confronted by knowing that there really are still real heroes in this world. Brokaw's book, The Greatest Generation, talks about real, bigger-than-life heroes. The narratives in that book actually fit the heroes. McCain, in a sense, was a hero, if for no other reason than the fact that he sat in a Viet Cong prison camp for 5 years, and he lived through all of it. But in our desire to make McCain into one of those bigger-than-life heroes that we read about in Tom Brokaw's book, we've spun too many fanciful yarns about John McCain. The most significant yarn is that because he pulled through the hell of Vietnam, he somehow is uniquely qualified at 72 years old to pull America out of the many miserable crises that he and his own political party have created for all of us. You see, with hero worship, we have a tendency to forget that John McCain, more than 90% of the time, supported every single policy decision that was ever put forward by George Bush, who today has a 25% approval rating by all the Americans that he has caused to suffer for 8 pathetic years. You see, unfocused hero worship causes us to overlook facts, important facts. Undeserved hero worship would have historians forgetting about the McCain SNL scam that cost mom-and-pop retirees the only money that they had to live out their golden years. Brokaw's quality of hero worship allows all of us to gloss over the small facts that help us understand the truths about the candidate John McCain instead of truths that we want to create about him. It puts us in a position where if we're not careful, we become uncomfortable talking about the fact that he graduated almost last in his class at Annapolis and how his admiral father had to go to extraordinary lengths just to get John McCain in that academy. Uncontrolled hero worship causes us to gloss over the facts about McCain's raging, mostly uncontrollable temper, and that's dangerous, where we have a man who can start a world war with one executive order. When we think about McCain, we owe it to our children not to be drawn into that hero worship state of mind when we consider that Navy pilots who flew with him called him John McNasty because of his erratic, bizarre behavior that played a part in him negligently crashing 4 airplanes because he couldn't take directions, because he always wanted all things only one way, and that was the John McCain way. Undeserved hero worship, if we're not careful, is going to have us believing that John McCain actually is a maverick instead of just an erratic, unpredictable personality who was born into privilege and never learned how to play with other children. When you start wishing for a hero, understand that Brokaw's book, The Greatest Generation, is filled with heroes, bigger-than-life heroes. But avoid what Brokaw has been unable to avoid, and that is you need to avoid creating great American heroes by creating narratives that in our heart of hearts we know simply are not true.
The PAP Attack on Air America Radio Network.